God is good, He led me to where I'm at. Sometimes I feel like giving up, you're giving in. But everything happens for a reason. It won't always be blue skies ahead. Sometimes you might need a helping hand, just like iron sharpens iron, making me stronger, calling me higher. When we come together, just like iron sharpens iron, making me stronger, calling us higher. When we're helping each other, we're growing together.
Thank you for listening to ZJoyVI, the USA, UK, Canada, South America, Africa, Australia, Estonia, Switzerland, the Caribbean. Let us know where you're listening from. Contact us on www.zjoyvi.com or WhatsApp us at 1284-346-1291.
Our Lord and our God, Father in heaven, how grateful we are on this brand new day that you've afforded us the privilege of eternal life. On this day, God, we join in commemorating your death on the cross of Calvary. Father, we remember it with grief, but we remember it with joy because we know the end of the story. We know the reason why you died, Father. And we want to say thank you this morning. Father, we thank you because we can look at our own lives and we can see how many times we have faltered and failed and sinned against you and misrepresented you, God. And yet you said, because you died, we can live. And so, Father, we thank you for that privilege today, that we can come boldly before the throne of grace and mercy and access that forgiveness and restoration that you have for us. We thank you, Father, for the privilege. We thank you that so many times we have sinned against you, God, and you have forgiven us because we asked. Father, help us not to take that for granted. Help us, God, that the things that we did yesterday, even or even this morning, that misrepresented you, Father, that we will get over those things, that we will be stronger and wiser, and we won't do them anymore. Father, help that we may leave all of our sins behind, recognizing the sacrifice that you paid on the cross of Calvary for our sins. So, Father, once again, we pray for forgiveness. We pray, God, that you will receive us as we come repentant, boldly, with confidence before your throne today. Have mercy on us, Father. Create within us clean hearts. Restore within us, God, the joy of your salvation. Thank you once again for the ultimate sacrifice, Father. Help that if any a time that we would reflect on that gift, God, it's today. But help us, God, to be joyful as well, knowing that Easter Sunday is coming. Hallelujah. We thank you, God, for the account in the Word that you have provided for us to encourage us, to strengthen us. Father, help us that we may live the lives that you want us to live so that we can gain that eternal life. We thank you, Father, that even though we may have some issues, health challenges, relationship issues, financial issues, God, that we can place them all at your footstool and know that you are in charge, you are in control, and you are well able to take care of us. So, Father, with that knowledge, we come before you today. Just saying thank you. We are so humbled, God, that you would call us your own. We are so humbled, God, that in spite of our past, our future is guaranteed with you once we obey your will. So bring us to that place, Father God, we pray. And we thank you for all of the blessings that you continue to bestow upon us. Bless this ministry. Bless the ministries of those who are listening and those who we represent, Father. We pray for those among our number who don't know you as their Lord and Savior, our family members and friends who are unsaved. God, we pray that by the lives that we live, Father, that they may see you in us and be drawn to call thee blessed. We thank you one more time for what you're about to do in this place today. We give it all up to you, Father. We leave it in your capable hands. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray with thanksgiving. Amen, amen, amen. Now, I want to just welcome each and every one of you to the Morning Joy Experience, and I want to open the phone lines right away. If there's somebody who is so grateful this morning that Jesus died for their sins, who wants to pray, who wants to testify of the goodness of God, the phone line is open right away. +1 284 346 1291. If there's a day that we should not shy away or hesitate to, you know, call in and just give God some praise, it should be today, as the world commemorates the death of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Let us who know him just give a high note of praise. Just tell Jesus thank you for dying. Just pray for those who don't know him as their Lord and Savior. Let's just make an effort today to be more resolute in our purpose to serve God, grateful for the gift that he has bestowed upon us. Amen. So that's it for my welcome. I welcome each and every one of you individually and collectively. And I pray that as we worship the King of Kings and Lord of Lords today, that we will be blessed. And as we are blessed, that we may, you know, just go on out and bless others. It's not a sad day today for me at all. I am so glad that Jesus died for my sins. I was filthy, my God, but he died and he said, come, Angela, come. I recognize that you're a sinner and I also hear you repenting. I want to forgive you. Just come. So I thank God for that today. Coming up at the top of the hour, Sister Emelda Boyer will be in with our devotions. And we believe in God that there's a word for all of us. So we stick and stay for that. In the meantime, please like and share the stream as much as you can. I've already done my part. You know, sometimes I get so busy and tied up back here that I don't remember to do it, or I don't have the time to do it. But I have done it. I've shared it on the ZJoyVI Facebook page. I've shared it on my personal Facebook page. I've shared it on my WhatsApp status. Wherever you can share it this morning, please share the link so that somebody out there can come to know Jesus as their Lord and Savior, so that we too can be strengthened in the Lord. Amen. We give God thanks for that. Hallelujah.
Abba Father, Lord, I call you Daddy. You are my strength, even in my weakness.
Very pleasant good morning to you. Thank you so much for calling ZJoyVI. You are live on the radio. Go ahead, please.
Good morning, everybody. Blessed Good Friday. Almighty and most merciful Father, Lord God, we thank you. We thank you that we are alive this morning. Whether we are in pain, whether we don't know where our next meal is coming from, we are alive. And for that, we say thank you. Lord, as we commemorate the first Good Friday, we give you praise. We do not have to hide. We are not living in fear, oh God. We give you thanks that you send your Son to save us from our wretchedness. We are people gather here this morning. You know our foolishness and our sins are not hidden from you. Help us, Lord, to continue to live the life that you want us to walk. Let us tread on that path, Jesus. Father God, this morning I'm asking you, humbly, Lord, to remind us how subtle the enemy could be. Lord, we do not only sin in action, we sin in thoughts. Maybe we sin in thoughts more than anything else. Cleanse our thoughts, Holy God. Father, teach us to be the persons you want us to be. You called us to be. Mighty God, let us see when the enemy is trying to nip in. God, here I am, asking you to look down on me and asking you to keep me, because you know, Lord God, what is going on right now. You know the thoughts that came to me, but I had to say, no, it's wrong. Father God, thank you for restraint. Thank you for reminding me that vengeance is yours. Remind your people on this platform, God, there is nothing you cannot do. Father, we always want results quick. When we say, Lord, help us, we want the result now. But give us patience. Help us to remember that your timing is never too late. Your timing is the perfect time. Father, I am asking you this morning for the sinners out there who do not know you as Lord and Savior, men, women, boys, and girls. They are of age and have understanding. Help them, God, to go where, put themselves in a place where they would hear your word, where your word would prick them and they will yield to the Holy Spirit. Mighty God, you know the burden on my heart for my own children. I bring them before you to the Holy God. I bring back to you, O Holy Father. I bring on you, dear God. I ask you, Lord, to speak to them. Lord, let the honey return to her first love. Mighty Jesus, speak to my son, Bassanio. Show him the road that he is on is the road to destruction. Is the road that would not give him peace. I'm not ashamed and I'm not afraid to call his name on public radio. He's my child and I want the best for him. My God, we bring Stacy before you, Father. Help her to keep holding on, Jesus. You know her battles, you know her ups and downs. Help her to stay strong in you. I bring my son Conrad, Holy God. Keep him, guide him. Help him, Father. You know, oh God, only you know what he has to face. Help him, Jesus, to keep strong in you. Help him to keep strong in you, dear God. Two for you and two against you, Lord. I want the two against you to come in, Jesus. Bring them, Holy God. Father, for every mother, every parent who is hurting now because they're looking for their children to come to you, help us not to give up, to keep praying. My God, sometimes I feel like saying, why should I? Why do I? But I know it's my duty, and I know you are listening. Father, the boys and girls, the young people who think that life is theirs and they can control their own life, my God, send preachers. Send friends, no matter what the world may be. Let them hear that you, O God, is the ruler of this world. You created this world. Satan cannot have your people. Bring those to you, O God, some that are backslidden. O Holy Father, remind them about your goodness. Send them back on memory lane, God. Send the backsliders down memory lane that they would come back to you, Holy Father. My God and my Redeemer, I ask you to touch Evangelist Burns this morning. My God, continue to be her guide, her shepherd, priest, and king. Touch every computer, every instrument, every what appliance, whatever, Holy God, to keep ZJoyVI on air. My God, bless everyone who participate, who contribute to the morning joy experience. Bless everyone who contribute financially, Holy God. Lord, bless everyone, but those, my God, who contribute financially, may you continue, may you increase their finance so that they may increase their giving. We give you praise, we give you thanks. Hold us close, God, in the palm of your hand. We cannot do anything on our own. Help us to depend on you. Remind us who we are. Father God, I bring to you the ministers of the gospel. Lord God, you know every single one by name and number. God, you know those who are compromising. You know those who are faithful and true. Mighty Jesus, strengthen and continue to strengthen the faithful ones. Lord, those who are doing their things and think that you are not seeing. They know you are seeing, but they seem not to care. Father God, pull them in. Help them to resist the devil. Let them preach and teach that the words that would help people to live worthy of you. My God and my Redeemer, whatever I fail of asking you on this pleasant Good Friday morning, you know the needs of everyone who has gathered here. You know the hurt, you know the pain. There is nothing you do not know. There is nothing hidden from you. My God, have mercy on us all. Bind us together in love. Keep us safe. And God, as we go about this day, we can say, hallelujah, Christ is risen. We have a risen and ascended Lord. We can say, praise be to God. Let us thank you not with lips, but from the depths of our heart. Let us show you our gratitude, Father God. Help us, Lord, to be light and salt. My God and my Redeemer, hear me, I beg again. Be merciful to us. Be merciful to us. Show us where we are going wrong. Strengthen us and lift us up where we are going right. Help us to be encouraged, Lord. Your word is a lamp to our feet. Let us use your word, Father God. Bless us, keep us, guide us. And in Jesus' name I ask. Amen.
Amen,
bless
amen.
Lord, my God and my Redeemer.
Glory to God.
Family and friends, I want to remind us all, the enemy is very subtle. When you stop doing the things that you used to blatantly do that pleases him, and he see you on the right road, he tries. He comes in ways. I'm telling you, friends, last night, I did not go to bed until 1 o'clock my time, which would have been 2 o'clock AST time, because I was there making sure that enemy don't penetrate me. Yes, there are things that I should not say that came to my thoughts to say. And I say, God, Father, vengeance is yours. I cannot do evil, well, saying evil things to get satisfaction. Satan has no hold on my, I'm not going to give Satan a grip. He had me for years. I was water baptized in 1987. And as the old saying goes, I did not last as long as Miss Trini Fire. I recommitted in 1999. I don't even remember how long I recommitted for. But this time, I know he's not pulling me down and he's not going to get me. Friends and family, hold on. Hold on. We know he named the enemy and his job is to see how much he can destroy. But he can create. So he will not be able to destroy us. Our Creator, our Heavenly Father, will hold us if we hold on. There is a song that says, take a grip and another grip. Hold on to Jesus and never let go. Let us hold on. No matter what, we would know when we slip, we would know when we are wrong, because God's Spirit would tell us. So when we see, when we know we slip, just acknowledge it and talk down to the enemy. Let him know he belongs to hell and trample him and beg God to keep us. Let him keep us. Keep blessings, my friends and family. Blessings.
God bless you, my dear sister. Thank you so very much for calling. We appreciate the prayer. We appreciate the testimony. We appreciate the encouragement. Glory to God. We are praying to a God who answers prayers. He is the Lion of the tribe of Judah. Hallelujah. The one who died on the cruel cross of Calvary for us.
Lion of Judah.
Is there anybody else who is grateful to God for Good Friday? Anybody out there who is grateful to God for Easter Sunday? Anybody out there who know that they were filthy and were it not for God, they would not be here this morning? The phone line is open. WhatsApp audio 284-346-1291. You can pray, you can testify. Come boldly before the throne of grace. Come boldly, come boldly. When we come boldly to God's throne of grace, we will receive mercy. We will find grace to help us in the time of need. He is the Lion of Judah indeed. Hallelujah. If you're grateful, please call. Somebody who has never called before, come on, show God how grateful you are. Sometimes we give God lip service and we don't translate it into our actions. I'm praying that for me today, that even as I come on here and encourage you, that I will be encouraged into action in Jesus' name. It's not always easy. The temptations come, but we can resist the enemy. Thank you, Jesus. Evangelist Bridget Blucher, as we continue musically. It's Good Friday, but we're celebrating the goodness of God. We're celebrating the sacrifice that He made. Welcome, everybody, from the US, the UK, Canada, all over the Caribbean, the Cayman Islands, and the Bahamas. Welcome, welcome, all of the Caribbean Islands. Welcome, Australia. Welcome, Switzerland. Welcome, Africa. Welcome, Virgin Islands. Good morning. You are live on the radio. Please listen to the phone and go ahead now, please. Thank you so much for calling.
Good morning. Go ahead. Good morning. And happy Good Friday. I am so happy for this day. I just called to just share a word of encouragement. You know, I'm so thankful to God for salvation. And I'm so thankful to God that He has saved me and He has given me another chance today to wake up, to be on top of the world in praising Him. I just give Him all the glory and the honor, and I just want to let others know that Christ is no longer on the cross. He has risen from the dead, and that He's alive and well, and all we have to do is to accept Him as our Lord and Savior and do the things. When Pilate couldn't find anything, he went to wash his hands, but then the blood is still on his hands. And I want everyone to know that we cannot afford to have the blood on our hands, but to have the blood to wash us from our sins. And I'm so thankful to God this morning that I can praise Him not in the tomb.
But God is alive and well in my heart. He's alive and well in my heart. And I can praise him and I can give him all the glory and the honor. I just, you know, sometimes I reflect back on the things that I used to do and the, you know, things I used to, I reflect back. And when I think of the things I used to do and to know that he could have cleansed me. And, you know, and I am here to praise him, you know, and I'm just glorifying God. I'm just glorifying God because of his righteousness and his goodness towards me. And I just want to let him know that I appreciate him. I thank him. I praise him. Words cannot express my gratitude. Words cannot express my gratitude to what God has done in my life. And I give him thanks. I give him all the praise and the glory. I do not matter what people might say. You know, this morning I had planned that I made some mistakes in my former years, but and I said, you know, Lord, I felt like I was going to get another dip, but it wasn't possible for me to do it this morning because, you know, transportation and wise, but and because of my disability. But I give thanks to God that in my heart I'm rejoicing. And I wish everyone could see that I thank God that when I made the mistakes, when my vessel was destroyed, it did not show the clear way. It took me and he saved me and he made me choice. And I'm so grateful to God because, you know, I could have passed and gone in those days, but God said, no, no, I'm giving you another chance. And I'm so thankful to him for the chance that he has given me. And I mean to serve him. I mean to serve him. I mean to serve him until the end. I just ask that you continue to pray for me and keep me strong. You know, keep me strong that I can continue. I can't move, but I can call and give a word of encouragement. Because that's what I use my phone to do. I don't use my phone to gossip like I used to do anymore. I use my phone to encourage people. To encourage people. And if somebody calls my phone to gossip, I just cut them off. I just cut them off. And sometimes they'll call back and say, what happened? And then I cut them again. Because I know. Yes, I know that God has cleansed me and he has changed me. And the things I used to do, I do them no more. Sister Angela, I'm praying for you. And I'm praying that God will continue to keep you on the ear. Keep this program because it's been a blessing. And I trust and hope that, you know, others will hear and will listen and will change their thoughts and their minds and their hands and their hearts to worship the true and living God. We just give him thanks and we just give him all the glory. My name is Sister White from Jamaica, and I am giving all the glory and the honor to God for the day that he has saved me and keeping me.
Sister White, you mentioned that you have a disability. Do you care to tell us what that is?
Okay. I have an eye problem. And one of the eyes, the retina, is gone completely. And the other one, it is going. It's not gone, but it's going. But, you know, the Lord is keeping me. And I know because I have asked him. I said, God, when I found out that I was having this eye problem and one was very bad, I said, Lord, do not allow me, oh God, to be blind in both eyes that I cannot see. And thank God I can't read the scriptures in the Bible, and I can't can't make, sometimes it's hard for me. I use the magnifying glass, but it's still difficult. But thanks be to God, I can move about and do everything for myself, right? And because of that, now it causes me, you know, to be just, I listen to the audios of the Bible. Right, on the phone, that's what I do. I listen to the audience, I listen to testimonies, I listen to services, and I just tune in. As I finish one and I can find another one, that's what I do with my phone. So I give God thanks that I can, you know, use my eyes, the little that He gives me to continue to serve Him. Right, and then again, I have been, you know, I'm diabetic and hypertensive. And then having a little kidney problem, and it's caused the feet to be swollen. And sometimes, you know, I can't even move like how I want to move. But I'm still around. I'm still moving. So I still give Him thanks because I'm anticipating my healing. I know He's going to heal me completely. But so I'm still waiting. Sometimes it might not be like a week talk and ask Him, but you know, gradually things will happen because I've seen His miracle in my life, and I'm trusting Him that He's going to complete everything when the time comes. Continue to pray for me, Sister Angela, and I. You know, sometimes I want to, sometimes to request the prayer, but, you know, so is my grandson helped me at times, but sometimes he's not here to put me on any of those things. But, you know, I listen to the prayer and I put them, I adjust them to myself when they are praying, and I call my name and say everything that I can, you know, continue to be intact with what is going on. You continue to pray for me, Sister Angela, and the other ZVI.
ZJoyVI. Thank you so much, Sister Jackie. You are such a great testimony. We thank God for you. You are not able to see 100%, but you can see enough to call in and testify. And I'm pretty sure that somebody else was encouraged this morning. A lot of times we tend to use something that's going on wrong with us. Oh, the knees are hurting. Oh, the eyes, I can't see too well. Oh, I have this, I have that, so I can't do this. Listen, we can do all things to Christ who strengthens us. And here's a sister in Jamaica who is visually impaired. She hasn't lost 100% of her sight, and she's using what she has to continue to glorify God. And she's not deaf. And so while she cannot read the word of God for herself, she can listen. And so we thank God for technology indeed. And we continue to pray for you, Sister Jackie White, out of Jamaica. Glory be to God. Thanks be to God for the testimonies. That's what we're doing here on today as we prepare to pause at the top of the hour for devotions with Sister Emelda Boyer. Evangelist Bridget Blucher, Lion of Judah, we worship you. The phone lines are open.
Lion of Judah, we worship you. Lion of Judah,
true.
Want to say thanks to those of you who have made it here on this morning. I know that some people would have had early morning church services. Some people would be preparing to go out to church this morning. Maybe some people would be having church this evening. I don't know what time. But I know that there are special Good Friday services in your various churches. We give God thanks for those of us who are not able to go out to church, that we can be here in this capacity to worship the King of Kings and Lord of Lords publicly, just saying thank you, Jesus, for being our Lion of Judah. Thank you, Jesus, for being our Savior. Thank you for being our Redeemer. Thank you for loving us so much that you gave up your life so that we can live. Thank you, Father, for redemption. Thank you for forgiveness of sins. Thank you for restoration. Such a beautiful thing. Hallelujah. Thank you for your provision. Thank you for your protection. Thank you for being a shield for us. Thank you for giving us wisdom, Father. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Lord Jesus. We have so much to give you thanks for on this day. Coming up at the top of the hour, Sister Emelda Boyer will be in with our devotions. In the meantime, we continue with music and the phone line remains open. You can call in and you can testify, or you can call in and you can pray. Come on. Ian Spencer, as we continue.
Love and justice, defender of the poor and weak, you are the God of everyday people. Lord, make glad you're not sleep. You are the God of love and justice, avenger of the poor and weak. Woe to the man with thief and rob from the poor, take away the little they have, build house upon the hill far from the people whose life they make so sad. Might not use the gun, never fire one shot, but them use their mind, we pick, we pocket. Politics, fake religion and miseducation, things we make for good, them turn them in a weapon. You are the God of everyday people. I know, Lord, you're not asleep. You are the God of love and justice, defender of the poor and weak. You are the God of everyday people. Lord, may glad you're not asleep. You are the God of love and justice, avenger of the poor and weak. The widow them of all and the elders too. Oh Lord, we don't know if it do. Work so hard, so long, put down a little pension. No, we can't stretch, we buy food. Me see the fatherless, I look life on the street. Nobody know the troubles they see. We're quick for call them crow and worthless. When some only escape is we do the wrongs for high society. You are the God of everyday people. I know, Lord, you're not asleep. You are the God of love and justice, defender of the poor and weak. You are the God of everyday people. Lord, may glad you're not asleep. You are the God of love and justice, avenger of the poor and weak. Another thing they panel on, but an abomination seems. Justice is for sale. Who can splash the cash, get away with the crime? If you're broke, you're goodly rot in jail. Guilty men go free.
I'm looking on the outside and it's looking very gray and dismal and gloomy. I can only imagine that it was like this on a Good Friday as they led Jesus to the Golgotha's hill, the cross of Calvary weighing heavily on his shoulder. Must have been a dismal day, a gloomy day for his followers who couldn't understand what was going on. But again, we thank God for Easter Sunday. Thank God for Easter Sunday. We thank God that Jesus did not refuse the call from his Father to sacrifice his life for you and for me. I am so grateful. We look at our relationships with our husbands, wives, children, friends. And sometimes when they do us wrong, it seems impossible to forgive because, wow, this thing really, really hurt. I can't forgive you for this one. Just think on the things that we have done to misrepresent Jesus. And he has said to us, come, repent. I will forgive you. I will restore you. I will bury your sins in the deepest depths of the ocean. I will remember them no more, no matter what you have done. Jesus forgives murderers. He forgives thieves. He forgives gossipers. He forgives those who commit adultery and fornication. He forgives those who sow seeds of discord. He forgives liars. He forgives all sins. Such a good God. Amen. We ought to be like Jesus. I know it's difficult sometimes, but it's only difficult when we don't focus on God, when we look at things from the natural perspective and we don't put our spiritual eyeglasses on. Yes, it will be difficult to forgive somebody for betraying you. Yes, it would be difficult for forgiving someone for trying to, you know, mess with your career or mess with your life. It will be difficult. But with God, all things are possible. Let us be like Jesus. Amen. Pastor Judith Gale, as we continue, heading on up to the top of the hour, taking it nice and easy on this Good Friday morning. Imagine the public shame that Jesus went through for you and for me. And yet there are people out there saying, oh, they're shy. They can't call into a radio station. They can't get up in church and testify because they are shy. They don't have the words. Hey, Sister Val, imagine that. There must come a time when we come out of our shell and we realize that our testimony would be impactful for somebody. And so we've got to testify of the goodness of God. Good morning. You are live on the radio. Thank you so much for calling. Go ahead, please.
Good morning. I'm not going to sit here and feel guilty one bit at all. I'm not going to feel guilty. I don't know why Jesus loved me. I don't know why he cares. I don't know why he sacrificed his life. Oh, but I'm glad, so glad he did. He left his mighty home in glory to bring to us redemption story. He died and he rose again just for you and me. Oh, but I'm glad, so glad he did. Family, I have a little testimony. It's a couple of years ago, but I've been a Christian since I was 16 years, but I've strayed. And I have three children. When I made my last child, I came from the hospital, I went home. My feet was swelling and I was going to the bathroom bleeding. I didn't know why. Eventually, I called one of my husband's aunt and I told her what was happening. She said, go to the doctor now. I said, why? She said, get up and go to the doctor now. Okay, I get up and I went to the doctor. The doctor didn't, he just, when I went to the office, he saw me. And then he said, he gave me some capsule and he sent me back home. He said, use this capsule and insert it. I just had a young baby, you know. He said, insert the capsule and let's see what happened. Family, I had placenta left in me for 8 days. 8 days. And when I went, while I was home, whenever I go to the bathroom, and then the devil doesn't tell you nothing good, you know. Although I had left Christ, I've left and wasn't walking the way God wants me to walk. The Holy Spirit had never left me. He never left me. When I went to the bathroom, every time I go to the bathroom and I sit, I feel like something climbing my stomach to come to my mouth. And I would stick my hand deep into my stomach and it would just go back down. Every time I go to the bathroom, the same thing happened. Eventually, I couldn't stand on my feet. I had to go to the hospital. And I had this leftover product in me for 8 days. And I knew it was the Holy Spirit who told me what to do. I should have been dead a long time. I'm sure a lot of people who would have had this problem are dead. But I'm still here. And I just give God all the thanks and the glory because my kids are grown now. I'm here with them to enjoy them. They would have been motherless. But I give God thanks. I give him all the glory. And I thank him for dying for me on the cross. Hallelujah. Everybody have a blessed weekend.
Thank you so much, my dear. I tell you, the things that God has done for us from yesteryear, from today, the things that he will continue to do for us, I tell you, no man can do. And as I like what the sister reminded us there today, the devil doesn't tell us anything good. Yeah? The devil doesn't tell us anything good. So we thank God for Jesus, who is the giver of all good gifts. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Thank you so much for calling and testifying of the goodness of God. What he has done for us in times past, he can continue to do because he's a God who never fails. He never, 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 never fail. So let us continue to pray. And I want to remind us that coming up on this evening at 10 o'clock, tonight at 10 o'clock until midnight, we will have intercessory prayer. So please get your prayer requests in and come on back with us at 10 o'clock right here on this YouTube channel so that we can pray. We'll also be on our website, www.zjoyvi.com. And on our audio apps, TuneIn, Radio Garden, Online Radio Box, wherever we are, we thank God for the medium. And we pray that you'll be able to join us. To get your prayer requests in, please go to our website, www.zjoyvi.com. Click on the prayer request tab at the top. Or you can just email us at admin@zjoyvi.com. Amen. Thanks be to God. Coming up at the top of the hour, we pause for devotions. In the meantime, we continue to have the phone lines open. Yes? Evangelist Maxine Duncan.
I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff may comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Down in the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff may comfort me. Thou preparest a table in the presence of my enemies. Down in the valley of the shadow of death, I will deliverance. We are the prayer warriors to bring the power down. Yes, we need some more Deborah to war against the enemy. We need some more Barack to fight the war by faith. Say we need some more David to fight against Goliath. Yes, we need some more Moses to get us to the promised land. Deliverance. We are the prayer warriors to bring the power down. Yes, we need some more Deborah to war against the enemy. We need some more Barack to fight the war by faith. Say we need some more David to fight against Goliath. Yes, we need some more Moses to get us to the promised land.
We got to live like we want to live again. Amen. Glory to God. Want to thank God for this privilege of being able to be here on this brand new day. We are going to pause in just a couple of seconds, couple of minutes, and head into St. Croix in the U.S. Virgin Islands to welcome our dear sister Emelda Boye, who will bring for us devotions today. Thank you so much for calling in and testifying, family. After the devotions, the phone line will be open again. We cannot shy away from testifying of the goodness of God, because He did not shy away. Jesus didn't. When He was called to die on the cross for you and for me.
In the presence of my enemies. deliverance. We are the prayer warriors to bring the power down. Yes, we need some more Deborah to war against the enemy. We need some more Barack to fight the war by faith. Say we need some more David to fight against Goliath. Yes, we need some more Moses to get us to the promised land. We are the prayer warriors, intercede for your deliverance. We are the prayer warriors to bring the power down. Yes, we need some more Deborah to war against the enemy. We need some more Barack to fight the war by faith. Say we need some more David to fight against Goliath. Yes, we need some more Moses to get us to the promised land.
Will you be a Moses today? Will you be an Esther today? Will you be yourself and just serve God because of what He has done for you? Will you be yourself and just testify of the goodness of God so that others can know that there is a God who saves, especially those persons who used to do bad with you? Show them that there is good. Amen. Because one day, for sure, Jesus Christ will come back to save us from this sin-sick world. And I want to be ready. Glory to God. It's the top of the hour, and it's time for us to head into St. Croix in the U.S. Virgin Islands and welcome Sister Emelda Boye, who has our devotions for today. So as we listen, I just pray that each and every one of us will just give the Holy Spirit our undivided attention as she ministers to us today. Unmute, and we are ready to go. We give God thanks for today. Amen. Thank you, everybody, for coming on board.
Good morning. Good morning to ZJoyVI, Joy family. It is a beautiful day today in my neck of the wood. The sun is out. It is bright. Today, as we commemorate with the death of Jesus Christ, we want to celebrate. We don't want to be sad or to think of his death as anything sad. So let us celebrate that he died, he was buried, and he rose again. So we give thanks to thee. My devotion today is entitled Walking in the Favor of God. And I will be quoting from various scriptures, but my key scripture is taken from Psalm 84:11. And it read this: For the Lord God is a sun and shield. The Lord bestows favor and honor. No good things does he withhold from those who walk is blameless. And as I said, my devotion is entitled Walking in the Favor of God. What is favor? A few definitions of favor is acceptance, approval, a special privilege or right granted, preferential treatment. But the favor spoken about here is not just a favor of human origin. It is of God, and it comes from God. The favor of God can be described as tangible evidence that a person has the approval of the Lord. It is God stepping into one situation to make a worthwhile difference. The favor of God is not a feeling, and it's not something to earn. It is a blessing from the Lord. It is God's approval and acceptance of us. There is also a close association among favor, which is grace and mercy. It is the grace of God in our lives. The favor of God is the guarantee of his presence and the provision of his power to accomplish his special purpose in and through our lives. It is intended not for our convenience, but for our purpose, but for his purpose, sorry. It is God stepping into one situation to make a worthwhile difference. It is God's kindness towards us. The favor of God is the highway to connect our destiny. In Genesis 6, 8, the Bible says, "But Noah found favor in the eyes of the Lord." God had graciously provided Noah and his family the ark, a means through which they could escape from the flood of God's judgment against sin. Abraham received God's favor and was even called God's friend, and that's in James 2:23. The same is true for us today. When we favor someone, we want to be with them. We connect with them in a way we don't connect with everyone. In the same way, God shows favor to the ones who delight in, connect with, and give honor to him. What does it mean to walk in the favor of God? Walking in the favor of God is a choice that we get to make each and every day. It is not always easy, but it is rewarding. It is not about life without problems, but a life where we are equipped to handle them. Every child of God needs the favor of God to do what he's calling us to do. Through Jesus Christ, we are able to receive and to walk in the favor of God. Nothing can ever shame us because of God's favor. The favor of God will take a believer to places where money and qualification cannot take. It brings us to people we could never access on our own accord. The favor of God will bring opportunities into our lives which skills and hard work cannot bring. God seeks out those who love and obey him so that he can bless, guide, and protect them. This does not mean that everyone who found favor with God will not suffer difficulties. Jesus was the perfect example of finding his Father's favor, but it ultimately led to his death. And as today we celebrate the death of Jesus Christ, let us reflect on it. One thing Christian has to know, not to be overwhelmed by the problem we face even when things seem worse. Knowing, however, that Jesus has ultimately triumphed and he will meet our needs. According to Philippians 4:19, "And my God will meet all your needs according to the riches of his glory in Christ Jesus." We can trust that God will always meet our needs. Whatever we actually need on earth, he will always supply according to his will. Sometimes what we want to do in life can interfere with what God wants to do in our life, and the enemy will try to use that against us to lead us out of the presence of God. That is why when the favor of God is actively working in our lives, it will block certain things from happening, simply to keep us on the right path. So when our plans don't work out the way we want, it's because the Heavenly Father wants to redirect our focus. As the key scripture says, "No good thing does he withhold from those whose walk is blameless." That means God will give us the means to walk along his path, but we must do the walking. When we obey God, he will not hold anything back that will help us to serve him. That is the favor of God. When we walk in the favor of God, honoring him with our life, knowing who we are and whose we are, we cannot be defeated. We don't have to chase nothing in this world. When we believe and love God with all our heart, we have a guaranteed victory. God don't want us to settle for less than what he wants to give us. Jeremiah 29:11 reads, For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. This does not mean that we will not be spared pain, suffering, or hardship. This is a part of life in this sinful world. But it does mean that God will see us through to a glorious conclusion. Remember that the favor of God can change everything in our life. God can transform any difficult situation we face, whether in our family, our finances, our health, or relationship. The favor of God produces supernatural increase and promotion, as we see in the story of Joseph in Genesis 39. Joseph experienced favor because the Lord was with him. His diligent and positive attitude was soon noticed by the warden, and he was promoted to prison administrator. Joseph was successful in every task that was given to him. And we can read that story in Genesis 39, 2-4, and 21-22. When the favor of God is upon you, he can put you in the front line. You were once at the bottom, but God has put you in a place of power. God can put you in a position when most may say you are not qualified for that position. But you don't need the qualification of people. When God's favor is upon you, he will become your qualifier. Praise God. God will see your effort and can reverse even overwhelming situations. The favor of God produces restoration of everything that the enemy has stolen from you. Exodus 3:21 reads, "And I will cause the Egyptians to look favorably on you. They will give you gifts when you go, so you will not leave empty-handed." God had promised the Jews would have favor among the Egyptians, even as they leave a ruined nation behind. When the favor of God is upon us, he will cause even our enemies to look favorably upon us. All that you have lost will be restored. All what the enemy has taken from you will come back to you. Praise God. God's favor produces great victories in the midst of great impossibilities. In Matthew 19:26, we read, Jesus looked at them and said, "With man, this is impossible, but with God, all things are possible." God can do all things according to his will in our lives. But it all starts with having faith and believing in him. Whatever opportunity that we thought we missed out on, God can give us another opportunity. Everything that we have, even denied, can be reversed by the power of God and by our faith in him. That is the power of God upon us. The favor of God produces recognition even when you seem the least likely to receive it. In 1 Samuel 16:22, we read, "And Saul sent to Jesse, saying, 'Let David, I pray thee, stand before me, for he has found favor in my sight.'" When God's favor is upon you, he don't look at the outward appearance. God loves us for our whole being, not as we outwardly appear. The favor of God opens door and make possible what seems impossible. We see when Esther obtained favor as a result, she saved her people. And that is in the book of Esther, chapter 2:17, which reads, "And the king loved Esther above all women, and she obtained grace and favor in his sight more than all the virgins, so that he set the royal crown upon her head and made her queen instead of Vashti." When the favor of God is upon us, he will choose us above others. He will give us new opportunities. It is not about our background or what we did in the past or even our education. It is about what we carry on in the inside. And that is the love and the favor of God. Understand that God is in control. He may be placing you in a position so you can help others when the need arises. The favor of God provides us with protection and blessing as we please Him. God can grant this kind of favor at any time to any person. The Bible says that it is you who blesses the righteous man, O Lord. You surround him with favor as with a shield. Psalm 5:12. So how do we gain that favor from God? Here are a few ways. We gain the favor of God by listening to him, with our time, by being obedient, with our service, by being humble, by honoring him, and by building kingdom relationship. If we want to gain the favor of God, we must listen. Psalm 32:8 reads, I will instruct you and teach you in the way you should go. I will counsel you with my loving eye on you. In order for us to know the will of God in our lives, we must listen to him. Do we take the time to listen to what God is saying to us? And how do we do that? We do that by identifying his voice through the consistency of scriptures. The second one, we gain the favor of God with our time. If we want to gain the favor of God, we need to keep him as priority in our life. Find the time to be in communion with God, spending time with him in our day, stepping out in faith. We gain the favor of God by our obedience. Every action of obedience adds favors, but the question is, will we obey? Favor will come to those who obey God and his word. The area in our lives where we don't have favor are the areas we don't have obedience. Favor is the reward of our obedience. We gain the favor of God with our service. The person who is not willing to serve others will remain the same. Everyone who serves with a pure heart, God will always promote them. As you serve, you acquire favor. God will reward you. We gain the favor of God by our humility. God gives grace to those who are humble. Humility is the total dependence on God. Those who are arrogant don't think they need God's favor and they depend on their own ability. However, those who are humble understand that without the favor of God, their prayers won't be answered. Without God's favor, they are limited in what they can do. We gain the favor of God by honoring him. Honoring God is something that should be done voluntarily. It must come from a heart that values God. If we honor God first, he will reward us. He gives favor to those who honor him. And the last one, we gain the favor of God by building kingdom relationship. God's favor flows out of a consistent and healthy relationship with him. And that comes through continuing in total obedience to the word of God. Build kingdom relationships first, serve people's need, and then share your faith and proclaim the kingdom of God. Without the favor of God, we will find it difficult to make it in society where wickedness and corruption abound. And in closing, the word of God tells us that there is a time when God shows favor to his children. Isaiah 49:8 reads, this is what the Lord says, in the time of my favor, I will answer you. You can experience life to the fullest and walk in the favor of God. As a child of God, even if you have never received favor in the past, release your faith and believe you can have it in all areas of your life. God's favor is for everyone who believes. The moment you start to believe, you receive Jesus Christ And when you receive Jesus Christ, you will receive God's favor. Proverbs 8:35 says, "For whoever finds life, for whoever finds me finds life and receive favor from the Lord." Seek to please the Lord and expect his blessing. If you truly want to walk in God's favor, it's not about who you are, but who is inside of you. Obey God today and know that wherever God leads you, his favor will follow. May the Lord smile on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord show you his favor and give you peace. Lord, we pray the blessing of our key scriptures to our key scripture today, which is Psalm 84:11, over our life. Help us to walk in your favor by listening to you, by giving you our time, by being obedient to you, by serving and not being served, by being humble, by honoring you, and by building kingdom relationship. Waken our hearts each day to seek you first as we live the life you intend for us. I pray that each heart receive a word of encouragement, and as we go our separate way today, that we will be encouraged and be a blessing to another. We thank you in no other name than in the name of Jesus. God bless everyone and have a reflective day. Over to you, Angelis Adjutila.
Thank you very much, Sister Emelda Boyer out of St. Croix in the U.S. Virgin Islands. God's favor. I feel favored this morning. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Did anybody catch the steps that you can take to receive the favor of God? It's there for all of us, you know. How do we get God's favor? How do we gain God's favor? We've got to listen to his word. Amen. We've got to use our time in service. We've got to obey him. We've got to be humble. We have to honor God in all of our ways. And we have to build a kingdom relationship. Psalm 84:11. Thank you so very much. The Lord is a sun and shield who bestows favor and honor to his children. And no good thing will he withhold from those who walk blameless before him. May all of us walk blameless before Almighty God today. We thank you, Sister Melly, for that devotion this morning, walking in the favor of God. Too many of us try so hard to walk in man's favor. We try to please man when we really should try to please God. Amen. We ought to please God. It's nothing that we can earn. As Sister Melly says, it's just a blessing from the Lord. Amen. It's just God's approval and acceptance of who we are. Blessed be the name of Jesus. I want to walk in God's favor. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Sister Melly. Thank you. Well, the phone lines are open right away as we continue to just give God thanks for who he is. Thank him for the gift of his son, Jesus Christ. I thought we'd be having call after call after call as we reflect on Good Friday and what it means for us. I have a father. In the meantime, Lester Lewis, I have a father who never ever fails. I don't want to fail him today. Amen. I am here.
I have a father who never fails me. Jesus is my Jesus. Father, who never fails me. Rock of ages, he never fails me. He never fails me. My father never fails me. Anywhere I go, I want the world to know. Jesus Christ never fails me.
I am a blessed child. I am royalty. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Go ahead,
good
please.
Good morning. Good morning, Evangelist Angela. And good morning, ZJoyVI. I want to share my testimony as usual. Jacobs, you know, I was praying a little earlier, and when I reflect on the cross, I was saying to myself, God, I am so undeserving. And then when I heard you said that we must call him, the same time the song started playing, God never fails, but many times we fail. And I thank God this morning for sending his son to die for me. It is not just ordinary when you think of Good Friday. It's not just ordinary. I reflect on the pain that he went through, the crown of thorns and the nails, his hands and feet, and that spirit in his side, and that bitter gall when he drank and said, it is finished. Man, redemption has been paid. I said, God, I owe you everything. I owe you my all. You didn't owe us. You died. You knew no sins, but yet you died. And I reflect on his grace and I say, God, we don't deserve your grace. Your grace, your unmerited favor to us. And you lavish that grace. And I said, Lord, you know, after all we're going through, your grace is still, the measure of grace is just pouring out and is still available to those who want to receive it today. I'm urging you to apply to the blood. It is still available, the blood of Jesus. But I want to say thank you, Sister Melly. You know, I reflect, and I was working with an eye doctor some years ago. I worked with him almost 25 or more, so years. And when he ready to promote me, you know, I received the promotion. He said to me, I am not giving you this promotion because you are here from a very long time, but because of your obedience to God. I see that you are living that life, and because of that, here is this favor. And there are times when I go in and he would give me extras, you know, and he would say to me, it's the Lord who asked me to bless you because of you deserve this favor because of the life that you are living. And I am saying that we are not perfect, but we ask God to help us to strive every day of our life. And I really truly want to identify myself and join in, you know, with that. Sister Melly would have penned the word this morning to say thank God for his favors. Sometimes we go into different places and we ask, you know, for favor. And sometimes we don't even have to ask because, you know, God truly lavish on us, you know, those blessings. When we go into different institutions, we see people blessing us and running to help us. We think it's us, it's God favor upon us. So today, as we go through today and we reflect of his death, burial, and resurrection, I pray that all of us will continue and to be drawn closer to him and continue to do what he called us to do, to live a life of obedience. May God bless all of us as we go through this morning's program. God bless you, family.
Thank you very much, Sister Denise. That's one who doesn't hold back to testify about the goodness of God. You see, when God does something for you and you are grateful, you don't hold back. Amen? You don't hold back at all. Glory to God. If you know what the Bible says, you do what the Bible says. If you are living the life that God wants you to live, you will experience his favor. And when you experience his favor, when you're walking blameless before him and you receive his favor, you will want to serve. You will want to do all of these things to make sure that others benefit as well. We give God thanks for the word. I trust that, you know, we may not just pick out one aspect of the Bible or one aspect of a devotion and run with it, but we will, you know, look at the word of God holistically and apply it every way, in every aspect, to all of our lives. Thanks be to God for his word. You know, when we receive God's favor, we find ourselves on the mountaintop. And when we're on the mountaintop, very often we forget about those who, you know, are below. But let us reach down. Let us reach down today and bless somebody else. And let us reach down and help somebody else up. Let us reach down in service as we obey Almighty God. Happy Friday, everybody. It is Good Friday, but it's a happy, happy day because we know the end of the story. Thank you, Jesus, for the blood. Amen. Welcome each and every one of you. Thank you for being here. George Banton. Want to say good morning. Good morning. Thank you for calling. You are live on the radio. Go ahead, please, with your testimony.
Good morning, my sister. Bless the Lord, family. I am Sister Marcia, listening in Jamaica. One of your silent listeners. I advise. No, this is the person that voice note you. But oh God, God is good. I was living in Florida. I came home to take care of my husband. But one morning I was scrolling through Facebook and I found YouTube. I don't even remember, but I found this in a time when I was going through so much things. And, you know, I listened to this program. I listened because, you know, I don't listen to any gospel because I recognize that we have so much false religion and false things. But when I listen and I listen to your testimonies and listen to others, you know, and I've been going through similar things, some of the things, where some things I can't explain right now. But God has been faithful. He has been a faithful, faithful, faithful God. And I just want to give him all the glory this morning. This it's too much to talk. I can't express anything now, and some of the things I just can't talk, they know. But listen to me, my sister. We are in a warfare. It's a time of spiritual warfare, and the devil is attacking us left, right, and center. He's attacking us. I just came off my prayer line and I was telling the brethren, I was reading, telling them about, reading about Esther. When Esther, you know, had the banquet and she made a petition. She says she and her people has been sold, you know. And Azarias was asking her, who is it? And she said, the wicked Haman. We have some Haman spirit that want to see us, the true children of God, they want to destroy us. And if they can't, then we're not going for thief again, then we're not going to do the money business, and the cause of the attack our health, they attack our children, anything close to us, they attack because it is with the mind that we serve God. So when we get the bad news, it attack our minds. When we hear our children and our grandchildren suffering from mental illness with good children, it attack our mind. And if we are not careful, we lose our mind. But I said we have to fight dangerous. We can't fight, no play, the devil not playing with us, so we can't play no pretty. We can't play with him, my sister. The other day when I hear the testimony with the Friday, you say you get up and you go out and you did everything, and when you came home, you knock out. And God allow you for the run all the errands and carry your home. You could have knocked out over the steering. But him allow you to do all the errands. And you take your home. And you knock out there. And then the devil believes him win. And your bunks back in between over. Hallelujah. I said this morning, listen to me, we don't need to mourn. The victory is already won. It is already won. It is a done deal, my sister. This fight is a fixed fight. The devil fight a losing, but he might as well give up. Because there are some of us that we are sold out for Christ, no matter what kind of lick him come with. Yes, sometimes sometime in liquid sudden, and you start a stunted little bit. But it's like you get up and you say, where you the boy? And when you get up, you go back to him in a rage. Every time the devil attack me, I go back to him more dangerously. So this morning, I'm encouraging us as Christians, as believers, not even Christian, believers. As the people in the city are Christian, I don't know what they are up to. But those of us who believe the word of God, those of us who hold on solely, we don't have no other source to turn to but in word. In thee, O Lord, do I put my trust. Let me never be ashamed. Let me never be put to confusion. When our hearts is overwhelmed, Lord, lead us to the rock that is higher than us. For you, Lord, has been a shelter for us and a strong tower from our enemies. David says, slay them not, lest thy people forget, but scatter them by your power and bring them down, O Lord, our shield. He said, when they were sick, our prayer, we went down in sackcloth and ashes. We pray, and our prayer, we turn into our own bosom. We have some people where we are prayer for, are we deadly enemies. But David said, scatter them by your power, Lord. Let a fire go before us and burn out all our enemies. And let the hills melt at your presence, Lord. Listen to me, Sister Joy, we have to start to read the Psalms there with David. Where David write, because we now have no words to meet the devil. Our one words can't match up with him. So we read the prayer. When the Lord wanted a house to build, and David decided to build the house. God said to David, said, David, you hand full of blood, you can't build the house. So David said, all right, I have a son and he's young. So what I'm going to prepare the material for him. So we are David's sons. So David write the prayers for us, because David been through, so he write when go through for us, so we can use it to build our temple. We don't have to do the killing anymore. All we do use the word. Use the Psalms, read them. And he said in Psalms 112, he said, my heart is fixed. I will not be afraid of evil tidings. My heart is fixed, trusting in the Lord. There's a lot of evil tidings going around to get us fearful. But brethren, let us fix our heart. Let us fix our heart and the King this morning. If we fix our heart and the King, we won't be afraid. Jesus said, for the joy that was set before me, enjoy. Listen to me, brother, sister. Them go and despise us. I'm in a church for 27 years. I'm baptized and I am like a piece of dirt going in. Nobody recognize me. Then do me all manner of evil. Both here, I go abroad, I go Florida, I live the same thing. If I never know God for myself, I come out of church a long time, because some of the wickedest people in my meeting since I am in church. But I stand up as a, listen to me, God call me and he shield me and he protect me. And sometimes when I expect to see, I don't know what they want, I don't know what they left for, don't know. Because I am dear, because I am fixing the house of the Lord. I am fixed, God fixed me there. and I will not be afraid. Sister, hold your seat in Zion. You're doing a good work. People's souls have been blessed. Yes, some of you want church people, because we go against church tradition. Because we're not about church building, we are about kingdom building. We are ambassadors. We are in this world, but we are not of this world. We are ambassadors here, recruiting people for the kingdom of God. And this morning, I encourage my sisters, I encourage myself. You're going to hear more about me. You're going to hear about me, and very soon too, very soon, sooner than we think. But for now, sister, I'm saying, hold your chair, hold your seat in a Zion. Sit down like Rosa Parks, don't get nobody push out of your seat. Make we hold, we see them, they want to push we out, them want to take when looks push we out, them want to take when they can't push we out, them come in like say, my friend, and come like say, bless the Lord, my sister. And then come and say, them I pray for you, and then tell you all sorts of things. So you give, keep the word in your belief. God, no give you no utterance, we talk, shut your mouth. Hold your peace, my sister. Hold your peace. Because then when they can't catch with them, come round like friend, or then send somebody to come as friend. Then come with us some gift with them. No, say that one, then come with some gift. I'll tell them how weird with your gift, you and your gift go to hell. You don't want money from some people. You don't want no money from some people. Or if then give you, no, take it, put it in the business, take it. Give to somebody else, we have need. Take it, find food, give to hungry people. No, put it in your business. May God bless us. May God keep us and cause his face to shine upon us and lift up the light of his countenance upon us always. God bless you.
God bless you so much. God thank bless you. Thank you.
God bless you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
And all the listeners this morning that is thank listening, you. May the God of peace shine upon us. We are coming into some strange things are about to happen. But God said, won't let the righteous go down with the wicked. So, no worry about what's coming. If famine comes, we won't be hungry. All we need to do is use wisdom. Have a blessed day. A blessed day.
Thank God you bless so you much. Thank you so
love
much.
Love you.
That's a prophetic word, and I receive it in the name of Jesus. That's a silent listener, you know. She's not silent. Hallelujah. Big shout out to all of the silent listeners. Come out, and let us encourage one another. I was really, really encouraged by that. We send all the evildoers back to the pit of hell where they came from. Hallelujah. We are glorifying God. We are doing what he has asked us to do. We will not be discouraged. We will not be thwarted. We will not cow down. We will worship God in spirit and in truth. I'm going to hold on to my seat, my sister. I heard that. I will hold on to my seat. Nobody can give me a better gift than what God gave to me, his son, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Yes, they will come. They have come with all sorts of gifts. They have come. But I thank God that I am holding my seat, because I don't want a gift more than Jesus Christ. And I have Jesus. Thank you so much. And I know that somebody out there, somebody else received that word today. Blessed be the name of Jesus. when I tell you that each and every one of you, you encourage me. Even sometimes when there's negativity, I am encouraged because it teaches me patience. It teaches me wisdom. It teaches me understanding and meekness. It teaches me, amen. Each and every one of you, you encourage me. Thanks be to God. We started something here some weeks ago, some months ago, where we said, unmute. Come on now. We cannot be silent believers. Come on. Yes, I know that you're in your different ministries, and as the sister said, she was on a prayer line or a Bible study or something earlier on, and she shared what she shared there. That's it. What God has given you is not only for a select few. It's for as many persons as who would listen, amen? The Bible says go out into all the world, not just in your family, not just in your co-worker circle. Everywhere you get the opportunity, you should shout it loud and clear what Jesus has done for you so that others can be encouraged and blessed as well. Thank you very much, Sister Marcia, for calling in. Really, really appreciate that. That's a prophetic word right there for Angela, and I receive it in the name of Jesus. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I ain't got to worry about nothing because Jesus is on my side. Jesus died for me. Hallelujah. Welcome, everybody. Thank you for being here. We're heading on up to the top of the hour. Will there be another call? Got to remind you about prayer this evening. We have prayer coming up at 10 o'clock. Please send in your prayer request to the website, www.zjoyvi.com. Sister Melly, I heard you tying up your tongue this morning. ZJoyVI. Oh, my goodness. I am tying up my tongue. So by the 10th anniversary, I think we all ought to get it together, yes? It's no more JGR FM, no more Joy Gospel Radio FM. It's ZJoyVI. Get it together, Sister Melly. But I'm doing it too. I'm just teasing you. You know this. But anyways, prayer tonight. Prayer tonight. www.zjoyvi.com. Click on the prayer request tab at the top. Send in your prayer requests, all right? Or email us. Admin, admin at zjoyvi.com. And come on back tonight at 10 and let's pray. Amen. Remember to pray up the prayer team. Second chance with this medley right now. But the lines are open. Good morning, you're live on the radio. Please listen to the phone, and this is your cue to go ahead. Thank you very much for calling. Go ahead, please.
Good morning. That is Angela. I'm at ZJoyVI. This is Margaret with calling. I want to say thank you. I'd like to read a little passage, and then I'd like to give my prayers. You know, God is so good to me and to everybody. I fell and hit the back of my head and I had a big bump. I went to the doctor, did all kind of tests, got home last night very, very late from all the testing that I do, but I'm well. And praise God, thank God for everything. And God is so good. I'm trying to find my scripture. It says, Psalm 39, it says, I will take heed to my ways that I sin not with my tongue. I will keep my mouth with a bridle and the wicked is before me. I was dumb with silence. I held my peace even from good. And my sorrow was stirred. My heart was hot within me. And when I was moving, the fire burned, and I spake with my tongue. Or make me to know my end, measure my days, what it is that I may know how frail I am. But I thank you for letting me know that. Hold on, please. I praise him for the help of his countenance. Oh my God. My soul is cast down within me. Therefore, I remember me from thee, from the land of Jordan, of her mountains and the hills. Deep call. Yet the Lord will command his loving kindness in the daytime, and at night his sound shall be with me. I may pray unto the God of my life. I will say unto the God my rock, why hast thou forgotten me? Why go in mourning because of the oppression of the enemy? I don't know how to say it, but I give God thanks. Many times he saved me. I almost fell 1,000 times. I almost fell, and God kept my hand just given by me and held me up once I fell. But God is good. I want to thank everybody for all their prayers and all their prayers and love. You know, I'm healing. I know I'm healing, and I thank God every day.
Amen. Thank you so much for calling, sister. Take care of yourself, please. Take care of yourself. And, God is your helper, so continue to lean on him for sure. Testimony time. Oh, how he loves you. Oh, how he loves you. He sent his son, only begotten son, to die on the cross for you and for me so that we can be here. Will we come home and stay home? Let us not stray anymore. Good morning. Yes, good morning. Good morning. You're live on the radio. Go ahead, please. Thank you.
Good morning, my sister.
Good morning.
ZJoyVI family. I just want to celebrate with everybody the goodness of God. I want to acknowledge that Good Friday is a Good Friday because he died for me. And because of him, I am living under his mercies. I started the program today in tears because Good Friday is a solemn occasion for me because it seems as if there's always a challenge at this time. Just like my father, when he was baptized, walked into the wilderness and the devil tempted him. It seems as if the temptations are numerous at this time. And I want to thank God that he is a God who delivers. I remember sharing at one time that I believe I came out of my mother's belly talking. And my gift is the gift of talking. And I remember that this is one of the things I've asked God. I've surrendered to God because I don't want to use my voice for anything but to glorify him. Unfortunately, the enemy knows this. And the enemy comes to tempt. He comes to tempt it in order to have you use your voice. Yesterday on the job, I've been, first of all, for the whole period of Lent, I've been walking through the journey, the challenge, the 40-day challenge, the journey of Jesus' life. And I was ministered to time and time again by many different people. And during that time, I again surrendered. I surrendered myself. My job means a lot to me. I love my job. But my job is not given to me by man. Every job I do is given to me by Almighty God. So everything I do to his honor and to his glory. My colleagues will tell you, those who really know me, that I do no shortcuts. I take no shortcuts. There are those who call me anal. There are those who call me military. There are those who call me empirical, because as far as they're concerned, I pay attention to detail. My God is a God of justice. And I know he sees justice even when those around me do not see justice. And I'm asking him to intercede, because yesterday somebody came to me and demanded that I perform a task I know is physically impossible at this time. I am so tired. My kids are saying I look tired. I feel tired. And I am being asked to do more and more. I said to the person, I'm sorry, I cannot do this. She asked me that question at least 20 times, expecting a different answer. I said, you are harassing me. You are annoying me. You are provoking me because I cannot do this. In the end, she left with the same answer I gave from the very beginning. But she turned back to tell me I have a nasty attitude. I don't know how to behave. I'm asking Almighty God to help me to survive this because I only want to serve Him. I only want to work for Him. And I can only do what is physically possible under His mercies. Lord, today I'm going to worship You. I'm going to surrender again to You. And I'm going to respond to whatever it is You ask me to do. Lord, I ask You in Jesus' precious name. Amen. Thank You for Good Friday. Amen.
Amen, amen, amen. That one touched me to my core. Jesus, 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 Jesus. We're praying for our dear sister even now, you know. God, oh, thank You, Father. We're so thankful that we have the victory. We don't even know that we have the victory. But when we are going through the stuff, it seems so hard. It seems so hard. We're praying for strength for you, my dear sister. Stay on the wall. Like Nehemiah, don't come down. You know that you're doing something good. And if somebody's going to come and try to coerce you into doing something bad, we know they are sent by the enemy. Somebody said earlier on in their testimony that the enemy doesn't give you anything good. The enemy doesn't want anything good for you. But we know that God does, and God is more powerful than the enemy. And so we pray, Jesus, over you, my sister, over your workplace, over your mind, over your family, over everything that you do. Stay faithful. Stay being a woman of integrity. Stay being honest, because in doing so, you are serving God. And when you do so, He is pleased with you, and He will never fail you. He will never give up on you. Amen. He will never ever give up on you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Strength, Lord Jesus. Heaven is better than this, and that's where we're striving to go. Stay on the wall. Stay faithful to Jesus. Let us remember all of our brothers and sisters in prayer today. Some people going through some real tough times in order just to make a living. Some people don't have a job at all. Patricia Bowen out of Second Chance. Heaven is better than this. Hold on, my brother. Hold on, my sister. We come against the spirit of jealousy right now in the name of Jesus. You know, there are some people who look on you with your good up job, your good up position. They don't know how you got it. And you know, some people think that they're the ones who did this for you. They're the ones who did this for you, not knowing that we were being used by God. They were being used by God. I've had a situation like that, and I've been victim in a situation like that. I pray today that God will release each and every one of us from that stinking thinking that we are the ones who did things for people. We are the ones, oh, because of me, you survived. Because of me, you are here. Because of me, I did this for you. I did that for you, and you are ungrateful. Help us, God. Release us from that stinking thinking. And help us, Father God, to please, please, please support one another. Help us to support one another. When we see people in their positions, we don't know how they got it. Support them. Don't try to bring them down. God has a place for you and he has a place for me. Don't fight me down. Come on now. Don't be jealous of what I have or who I am. You are special in God's eyes as well. I am special in God's eyes. What he has for me, he has for you too. He loves me the same as he loves you. So don't come into my ministry. Don't come onto my job and try to tear me down and take what the Lord has blessed me with. Because guess what? You can't take it. You cannot take it. What is for me is for me. What is for you is for you. Let us support one another. Jesus, I try to help you, you try to help me. You know, if you're a supervisor or a manager in a place and your subordinates, they excel, you excel as well. Because guess who the CEO, guess who the boss is going to come and talk to? You. And you are the one who's going to say, well, my department this or my department that. And you get the credit as well. But if you're humble, as Sister Melly spoke about today, you will say, well, Sister Cordelia did do this, and it's because Sister Etta did this. It's because Sister Margaret did this, or Sister Marjorie did this. It's because Sister Pearl did this why I can claim that my department is on top. Let us not take credit. All the glory belongs to God. Amen. If we succeed, it's because of God. Yes, God has placed some people in our lives to help us. But I tell you, sometimes when people come into your way, they have some ulterior motives. And mighty God, you never find out until it's too late, when your heart done broke. Speak properly, Angela. Mighty God. When they done break your heart, or when you done break their heart, is when you look back and you can say, wow, so that's what was going on? So that's why she came? That's why he came? They wanted what I have? You don't even know what I went through to get where I am today. And I'm not perfect. We should strive for the mastery, family of God. Strive to be like Jesus. Oh, Father. You touch a con there, Sister Pearl. You touch a con. You touch a con. It's hot in. You know, there are some people who, you know, they are in their corner. No trouble, nobody. Then some people come on and they say, what she has there is good. What he has there is good. I want to come into that church and I want to take over. And they come in as subtle as the enemy. They pretend that they're nice. They pretend that they're kind. They pretend that they're loving. Until they woo, or what is the word? They you know, just inveigle their way in. And they try to take over. They try to make you lose your job. They take your friends from you because they go and they say all manner of evil against you. And these friends are so vulnerable and gullible and love gossip that they don't seek to find out the other side of the story. They look on you and they join in cutting you down. May God have mercy on all of us today. even in this very own ministry, we've had situations like that. So Sister Marcia, I tell you, when you spoke to me prophetically this morning, I receive it in the name of Jesus. This ministry, as we grew, we were cut down by people who decided that they wanted to take over. Mighty God, I didn't know. But I thank God for Jesus this morning. I thank God for Jesus. They'll come and they'll help. They'll give you nice things. They'll say nice things about you. But underneath, mighty God, they do more damage than good. Father God, help your children today. I thank you for spiritual discernment. I thank you that I didn't lose my mind. Hallelujah. I thank you that I didn't lose my mind. I thank you for the encouragers. I thank you for those who genuinely prayed for me, Father. There are people out there who are going through, mighty God. You heard from our sister this morning, Father. You know, because she's been talking to you. She shared this morning so that others could be blessed. Somebody ought to take a note this morning that God is more powerful. He is stronger. He is wiser. He is bigger. He is better. He is more able. He is well able to deliver you and to deliver me. So don't you worry, family. God's got you. Amen. Walk in his favor. Walk in the light. Beautiful light. Hallelujah. Thanks be to God for this day. God is good all the time, every time. And when he wants to accomplish something, he's going to find the right person. He's going to find the one who is trustworthy. He will find one who has faith in him. He will find one who will obey his voice. He will find one who will not be distracted, but who will remain focused and follow his instructions. I tell you, sometimes when people think that they're doing you bad and evil, they don't know your God. God can turn it around and use this evil for his good, his glory, and for your good as well. Continue to trust God, family. Don't give up. No matter what anybody's trying to do to you, hold on to Jesus. Hold on to your seat. Keep on praying. Keep on believing. Keep on being obedient to Almighty God. Don't give up. Don't give up. Giving up is not an option. Amen. I thank God for all of the true supporters. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Thank God for all of the true believers. The sister said, don't even call them Christians. We've got to be called believers. Because I tell you, if you believe in God, you will do what he wants you to do. Christians, they go to church and, you know, they hold a pew. They warm the pew. Mighty God. Help us to be true Christians. There shouldn't be anything called true Christians, you know. It should just be Christians. Because if you're a Christian, you're a follower of Christ. And there ain't no halfway business as far as that is concerned. No one foot in, no one foot out. Yes, I see the time. No one foot in, no one foot out. No lukewarm business when it comes to Jesus. You got to serve him 100% all of the way. You can't pretend to support somebody. You got to support. Come on now. There's room for everybody in God's kingdom. Kingdom building, Sister Melly. Kingdom building. Glory to God. I feel Jesus. I thank God for my struggles. And each of us, we've got to be able to thank God for our struggles. When I look back, I still wonder over the last one I went through again. I'm like, God, I thank you. I thank you that I'm still clothed in my right mind, because it wasn't easy. Because, you know, as I still try to give people the benefit of the doubt. I'm not perfect, but I know my God. I know my God. And I know that he has got me. I may not talk in tongues. I may not fall flat in my face in church. I may not fast and pray as much as I should. I am getting there. Help me, Jesus. Help me, Jesus. Walking in God's favor. I want to walk in God's favor. So glad I am on my own time, for real, for real. I don't feel like moving right now. I don't. God has a message for somebody. If there's anybody else who wants to call, come on, let's continue. It's Good Friday. Are you working today? I work every day, yes? I thank God for the Sabbath when I can rest. Blessed be the name of Jesus. But it's Good Friday, so let's linger a little while. Anybody else want to call and testify? We've got to come to the point in our lives, Christian people, believers, when we not only say we love, but we really love. No fakeness in God's kingdom. No pretending in God's kingdom. My mother used to tell me, God rest her soul, what done in darkness always come out in light. What done in darkness. And this is somebody who knew my mother very, very well. She used to tell me, my brother, what done in darkness always come out in light. Good morning. You are live on the radio. Go ahead, please.
A very good morning, Lady Burns. A very good morning, listeners. It's such a joy, man. I really enjoy it this morning. Well, I'm a constant listener. God has been so good, man, over the years and up to today. I am extremely grateful, you know. That word from that lady, man. I don't know if you remember a couple of years ago when I joined Joy Gospel Radio. I told you, CEO? You're the Margaret Alcock of Montserrat. And I was just saying it like I know it. Sometimes we don't give people credit for the things they do. I honor you, man. I really lift you up. I just want to give God thanks for you, man. And for me and my family, I come a long way, man. Oh, pretty grateful for your radio station. Okay? You have been a source of blessing to me, man. I got baptized in 2009. Anybody know me, know where I'm coming from. Not ashamed of that. I am who I am today. Nobody could take that. In Jesus' name. All right?
Amen.
You'll be blessed, sister.
Amen. He didn't tell us who he is, and I'm not going to say who he is as well. But
I am Clement Galloway Morgan, Man Lion.
That's
not
right.
Not ashamed of that.
They used to call you Man not Lion. That's how I know you from, yes, Montserrat. Man Lion. And people, yes, can just guess why, yes, they, sir, used to call you Man Lion. But the man is baptized and called by the name of Jesus Christ right now. And we give God thanks for you, my brother, and for your wife and your family.
Not ashamed of that, sister.
Oh, Jesus.
Not ashamed of that.
I am so encouraged.
They judge me for who I am, who I was, but I'm not that guy today.
Amen.
Thank God.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. You see, and I really, really appreciate this call, because this is a brother from Montserrat who I knew when he was, and he knew me when I was, you know. And people can, as he said, judge us from who we were, but we know who we are in Christ Jesus. All of my Montserrat people, just big up yourself right now. Thank you so much. God bless you, Brother Clement. Yep. He listens often. As a matter of fact, his radio is always on online radio box. You listen on, right?
No,
online radio box. He always listens on the website, and we give God thanks for you. Thank you for liberation, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Brother Galloway. God bless you, sir.
And you as well.
God bless you. Oh my goodness. When somebody know you from long time and they know who you were, Sister Pearl, you hear the man? You remember Man Lion? Lord Jesus, I thank you. I thank you for testimony today. We are going to linger. We are going to linger a little bit more, because you see, God, You see, God, hey, you can't test God, you know. You cannot test God. You're going to lose. So be on God's side. All of these years that I wasted, Father God, I am sorry. All of these years that I did all sorts of foolishness that misrepresented you, God, I am sorry. Oh, Jesus. But I know that you accept me now for who I am and who you want me to be. And I am going to be faithful to you. I am going to be faithful. The phone lines remain open. We're just going to linger a little bit more. We're just going to linger a little bit more. We're going to linger a little bit more. Thank God. Thank God. Good morning. Good morning. You're live on the radio. Go ahead, please.
Good morning, Sister Angela. You did not linger on this radio station by yourself, but that was ordained by the Holy Spirit. So long I want to call, but I said, let me give someone another chance. Let me see if someone else will call. Give someone another chance for them to call. But I'm saying, oh, they're not calling. Then I see 8 o'clock. I say, oh, my goodness, 8 o'clock. I missed it. But then I realize Sister Angela is still on after 8. I said, I got to call. Family, I just want to say thank you, Jesus, for all you have done for me. You know, when I think of the cross, last night I came up to my room and I had a party going on. It was only Jesus and I. And I was giving God thanks, you know, giving God praise, giving God glory for all he has done for me. It's almost like I was in a different atmosphere. I was just giving God thanks, because when we think of the goodness of God, when we think of the goodness of God and what he has done for us, how can we stay quiet? But we have to open our mouths and give him praise. I thank God that day when he called me, I vividly heard the Lord called me and he said, go up to the altar. I was 17 years old when the Lord called me and I responded. And I just want to thank God today for the cross. Had it not been for Calvary, had it not been for the shed blood of Jesus Christ, where would I be? You know, there are ups and downs, but you know what? Trials will come, temptations will come, troubles will come, because the Lord tells us it will come. But when it comes, the Lord gives us grace. He gives us strength, because his words declare that we are victorious. We are overcomers, for greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. So today, I am rejoicing for the cross. I'm rejoicing because Christ is alive. He is not dead. See, he is alive. And guess what now? He lives in our hearts. So today, I rejoice with you, Sister Angela. I rejoice with the saints of the Most High God, that God is alive. And I'm going to pray today. Father, Lord, we remember those who do not know you. Lord, there are so many of our unsaved family members, especially our family members who do not know you. Father, today we call out to you on their behalf. Father, we pray in the name of Jesus that your Holy Spirit, oh God, will draw them to the cross this morning. Holy Spirit, you will do a work in their heart and in their lives, that, Lord, they will come to know you, whom to know is life eternal. Father, it's not by might. It is not by power, but it's by your Holy Spirit. So we lift up all of our unsaved family members to you today. And we pray, Father, that you will have mercy upon them this morning. You will have mercy upon them this weekend. And as the world is celebrating and we are rejoicing about Easter, your Holy Spirit, oh God, will draw them to the cross, will draw them to have a relationship with you this morning. Father, we know that you come to seek and to save them that are lost. So this morning, as we lift up our family members to you, we pray that you will come and save them. You will come and set them free from the hands of the wicked one. So Lord, we give you thanks for salvation this morning. We thank you for saving our family, because your word declares, as for me and my household, we shall serve the Lord. So we thank you for that promise. We stand upon that promise this this morning that our family will come to know you, whom to know is life eternal. So we bless you this morning. We glorify your name. We thank you for Sister Angela. We thank you for this ministry. Oh God, I just pray a blessing upon this ministry as it continues to touch lives, as it continues to encourage souls. We thank you. Cover this ministry under the blood of Jesus. Cover this ministry. Praise Sister Father. Continue to provide for Sister Angela and her family, oh God. And Lord, as she continues to labor for you, Father, you will give her the strength and the grace. Touch her body physically, oh God. For by the stripes of Jesus, she is healed from all sicknesses and diseases. So we bless you this morning. We glorify your name, oh God. We exalt you. Father, we just thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Father. To God be the glory. Great things he has done. Sister Angela, God bless you. And I love you. Family, I love you. I love you. Thank God that day my sister introduced this station to me. I thank God for Sister Vanya for introducing me to this radio station. God bless you all, family. Have a blessed weekend. Amen and amen.
Amen. Love you too, Sister Martha. And of course, we want to just recognize Sister Vanya. She's one of our silent listeners. I tell you, Sister Vanya is always there. And she supports the ministry in more ways than one. So Sister Vanya there in Canada, we bless you. Thank you so much for being a part of our ministry here at ZJoyVI. Thank you for sharing. Thank you so much, Sister Martha, for calling in. I tell you, as Bishop Jethro says, it wasn't a mistake that we are lingering here. You hear the testimonies. Listen, man, God is amazing. I'm so glad that I work for Jesus. Amen. I work for God. Amen. Ain't nobody's going to call and say, but Angela, you're late. What happened? Don't bother coming. If you don't come in by 8:30, you're fired. Hey, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Yeah, I want to just give God a reckless praise this morning. Oh, King Arthur. Good Friday. As Sister Anicia says, it is a good, 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 good Friday. When are you going to wait to testify? When? When are you going to wait to come out of the closet and say, listen, God, I can't be silent anymore. I've got to unmute. When are you going to wait to tell the world what Jesus has done for you? When you're dead? No, sir. It cannot happen. When you're dead, that's it. When God provides the opportunity for you to testify, do it. You just never know who will be on the listening end, who will be blessed, who will be encouraged. Do you believe that there are people here who are living in sin day in, day out, day in, day out, and they know, but for some reason, something have them held there? The enemy's got a hold on them. They cannot come out of that adulterous bed. They cannot come out of that fornication bed. They can't come out of that lying mentality. They cannot come out of that self-righteous spirit because they are not allowing God. They're not submitting to God. They're not allowing God to do it for them. They're all up in themselves and they feel that, okay, I'm going to get out once in a while. I'm going to get out in a little bit. Just give me a chance. I just want to amass some riches. I want to build my house. I want to get further advanced in my job. I want to get some more friends, some more people in my corner. Give me a chance, God. Give me a chance. Now is the time, eh? Now. Not tomorrow. Not even later. When are we going to testify? Good morning. Welcome to ZJoyVI. You're live on the radio. Go ahead, please.
Good morning, Evangelist Angela. Good morning, my family. Good morning, good morning. Okay, I want to give God thanks and praise today that he died on the cross and he did not stay in the tomb. He's alive. And I want to thank God for you, Sister Angela. I want to thank God for you, Sister Angela, because when I first heard the program, I was just passing through and I heard this program and I stopped. But when I heard you said that, when I come to do that to you from the Adventist family, I said to my husband, wow, Moses, come and hear that. You know, she's a Seventh-day. And you are there, you're not about the 7 days, you are there for Jesus. And that's what I admire about you, there for Jesus, not religion. Some religions are so selfish, it's all about their religion. And you are blessing us so much, Sister Angela. You don't know. Now you know this morning I was not supposed to testify, but since God allow you to, you know, I said, okay, I'm going to take that chance. Maybe it's for me, Lord Jesus. You want me to speak and let the world know that you are not about religion. You are there about me, about my God. That's what you are there for. I tell you, when I heard, I said, Moses, come and hear that. You know, she's a 7 days. And she's not looking like that. She's just, you know, I was so amazed about you. So I want to give God thanks and praise for you. And I want to thank God that where I was, I am not where he wants me yet, but I am not where I was. And I'm just, you know, I'm just following him, listening to him, that he takes me to the path that he wants me to be. But I just want to thank him, because if I have to lay my path, it will take me the whole day, the whole tomorrow. So I just want to thank God that where I was, imagine calling to testify. That is a blessing, because my God, who would ever hold a phone to testify, or who would ever stand up? Because I was so shy and I couldn't talk, and I always believed I could not do, but this is God. So I just want to thank God. Because imagine we have a ladies rally today, and I said, no, I'm not going. I want to stay home by myself with Jesus. I said I'm going to fast from the phone, but here I am on the phone, but it's for the glory and God and for the glory of God. No social media today. It's me and my God today. And not only today, but at least I take that time to testify and to be with God today, to remember what he has done for me. And I'm just praying for my children that the life that they see in me, that they will want to live that life for Jesus. They are not there yet, but I want to live a life to, you know, like I always ask God, let me be the light to my family. We have a lot of families that are not saved. I just want to be that light to my family. They will see the difference, and they will come to know the Lord Jesus as the Lord. I'm just praying and let God do what he has to do. So I want to thank you, and God bless you. God bless you. And I thank God for the day. Nobody did not introduce me to that radio station, but I got it on my own through YouTube, and your face just attract me, like I have said before. I was just attracted to that face, and here I am up to now. God bless you. God bless you, my family. Love you all. Love you all. Love you all. Love you all.
Love you too, Sister Velda. Thank you so much for calling. Really, really appreciate that. Well, thank God for the face. I tell you, thank God for the face. Thank God for the smile, because, I mean, truth be told, you know, a physical attraction very often is what draws somebody, or what somebody does for you, or something is what generally draws somebody, until you get to come to know the person more intimately. And so I thank God that I have a face that draws people to him. What a thing. That is something that I never even remembered to thank God for. I probably wasn't even aware that this is one thing, this is a blessing, this is a gift that I can thank God for. Thank you, Father, that I have a face that draws people to you, that my smile draws people to you. It's not simple at all, you know. It's not simple. And, you know, I just give God thanks. Thank you, Father. Thank you, thank you. I'm living my best life now. Anybody living their best life on Good Friday? Mighty God. Thank you for lingering. Thank you for sticking and staying, family. We soon finish, all right?
Freedom to dance, freedom to sing.
If you have a testimony, if you are free to testify, come on. 284-346-1291. You should have that number in your phone, programmed in your phone by now. Minister Vern Prophet is helping us celebrate on Good Friday. Sister Magda in Anguilla says she found me by looking at my face as well. I found you by looking at your face too. Well, sir. And there's no makeup on this face, eh? Bless the Lord. Natural things. I am who God says I am. I am created in His image. And I need no enhancements. Glory to God. Now, I'm not saying anything about you folk who wear your makeup. If you wear your makeup, that's what you want to do, all right? But I'm not one for the makeup. I tried it. I didn't like it. I really didn't like it.
He can't stop me anyway.
Thank God for my face that draws people to Him.
He can't stop me anyway. No matter what.
A very young face, you say, Sister Wendy. This face has gone past half a century. You know? This face has been through so many things. It has faced so many trials, I tell you. It has been so sad for a couple of years. It has had so many buckets of tears rolling down. This face, man, it has been through, but God be praised indeed. This face has stood the test of time. And I'm declaring today that I am going to serve God for the rest of my days. Minister Vern. And just goes to show that each of us as Christians, as believers, we've got to be careful how we go about with our countenances, yes? Smile through the storms. Take the frown off your face. Turn it upside down into a storm. No matter what, God is good. He's in control. Amen. Let's go. Definitely like Moses. Moses is one of those ones who said to God, listen, God, I hear you, you know. God, I want to do what you say, you know. God, I believe in what you're telling me to do, you know. God, I know that these people want to hear what I have to say through you, you know. God, I know that they want to hear what you have to say through me. But God, I don't know how to get the words out, God. I am a stammerer. God, you know I cannot speak you know I can't do this, God. Why are you telling me to do this? That was Moses. That was Moses. And how do we remember Moses? He brought the tablet. He brought the Ten Commandments. He led the children of Israel to a certain point out of the wilderness, out of bondage in Egypt, through the wilderness. God has a work for you. He has a work for me. Yes, we're going to buck up on some trials and tribulations. We're going to buck up on some people who want to hold us back for whatever reason. People who say they are holding our hands, but in fact they are pulling us down. But God, hold fast, family. You are the head and not the tail. You are above and not beneath. God is with you. Come on, let's make some declarations. Sister Marlene from the TOP. Just in case you're wondering, we're going up until the top of the hour. I gotta go eat breakfast. Yes, I gotta be wise. Hey. What a day to get bonus coverage, Brother Charles. It's a day when we should be oh so grateful to God for Jesus. Monica, you're still there? Bless God.
Come on and give God a shout of praise. Release that sound into the atmosphere. Hallelujah. Let's go.
He's my healer, my provider, my protector, my strong tower, burden bearer.
Can you imagine seeing Minister Vern minister this song live and direct at our 10th anniversary? Somebody book Minister Vern already. Minister Vern is a big artist, and you have to book her, you know. I don't think she's going to charge us. You think she's going to charge us, Sister Martha? You think Minister Vern is going to charge us? I don't know.
He's my healer, my provider, my protector.
It is Good Friday, but we are celebrating. We thank God for Jesus, his death on the cross of Calvary. We know the end of the story. Easter Sunday is coming, y'all.
Over our families, over our health, our finances, our homes, over this nation,
I thank God that he's on our side all the time, every time. One more time for Minister Vern. One more time. Come in, Minister Vern. God on my side. When you see me shouting and celebrating the goodness of God, if you don't understand, excuse me. Wait a minute, we having a party? You all forget that you can call and testify? We can take another call or two. Oh, there you go. That's what I'm saying. We're partying, yes, but we can party and testify. Amen. Good morning. Good morning. You're live on the radio. Go ahead.
Good morning. Good morning, Sister Angela. This is Carol. I think this is a troublemaker. Yes. But to God be the glory. Great things he has done. So lovely the word. Oh my God, today is a special day for me. I know if I was in my homeland, I would be heading off to church. But you know, when you're in Rome, you have to do as the Romans do. But I want to still give him thanks. I want to still give him the glory, the honor, the praise. I want to tell him thanks this morning because he's worthy to be praised. Mighty God, I want to tell him thanks for this radio station, because you know, if it wasn't for this radio station this morning, I am telling you, my sister, maybe I would be just reading the Bible. But no, I can stand up, I can dance, I can glorify him, I can praise him, because he is Almighty God this morning. He is the all and all, the finisher. He is the first and the last. He is the beginning of everything. You know, my sister, sometimes we have to go through the fire, but God is there with us. God is in the midst of everything that we do this morning. And I want to tell you this morning, I don't know, my God, but I want to say this morning that is my all and all. Oh God, last night I did not sleep, because right through the night, I was there worshiping. And you know, today I am at work, and it's a 10-hour job. So I don't know how it's gonna be, but I'm putting God first, because he's the head of my life. He's the author and the finisher. I'm telling you, sister, God is good. He's amazing. He's miraculous. Oh, glory to God. I am telling you, oh, Jesus, I just feel happy. Maybe you wanted to wait for me this morning until I reach the work. But thank God. I know I can't call on a Friday morning, but thank God I am here this morning calling to give him the glory and the praise. You know, I am here this morning. So I just want to give a shout out to everybody this morning who is listening to your program, because this is a special morning, a good Friday morning. I want to tell everybody this morning that God is awesome. God is my, oh Jesus, my sister, I don't even have words to say this morning. I don't have words to say. Oh, I am happy. You hear me? I am so happy. I am happy, happy, happy in the Lord this morning. So I want to give you thanks, my sister, for your program. Thank you for everything. Sometimes I don't come in the chat room, but I am here. I'm still listening. You know, when you get one little work, because the whole of last year, you have to say, I didn't have anything. But since this year, God opened up a way when there was no way. He opened the door for me when the door was shut in my face. But I want to give him thanks. You know, if we don't give him thanks, the rocks and the stones will give him thanks. So I don't want to be like that. I want to send up my praises, because everybody's story is God's glory this morning. You understand? So God be for us. Who can be against us? So thank you, my sister, for your listening here. And I want to tell you thanks to hold on for me this morning that I can't call you. That I can call you, because sometimes you might be saying, oh, how Sister Carol don't come on this morning? But you know, sometimes I can't even talk on it because I am there worshiping. And right through, I left my home this morning going up to the bus stop, and it's about 1/4 mile I have to walk for the bus. And when the bus come, I have in the earplug in my ears. Come off the bus, I reach at work already. I don't even clock in yet, but I thief in the time. But God knows and him understand. Him say, we're not for thiefing, you know, but me have for thief time sometime to call and say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. So, sister, have a good day.
Thank you. Thank you very much, my dear sister. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for calling. And I tell you, I didn't know who I was lingering for, but God knows. And I give God thanks for my obedience this morning. Hallelujah. We are in a war, but we've already won. Glory to God. Pastor Mavia Providence.
Are you ready, soldier?
Thank you for lingering in the presence of the Lord today. Somebody is baking. Sister Monica is baking. Oh my goodness gracious me. I want some, Sister Monica. Good morning. Good morning. You're live on the radio. Go ahead, please.
Good morning. Good morning, Evangelist Angela. Sister Johnson Amoy. Mr. Amoy Johnson. Okay. I just called to say a very good morning to everyone. And I just want to give a testimony. You know, I'm so glad that I'm a part of the family of God. I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, because it is the power of God unto salvation. I've been through many deep waters, many a lonesome valley, but God has brought me over. I am glad that I am joined here with Jesus Christ. I am glad that God had gave his only begotten son, Jesus Christ, to die in my stead. He paid for my sins. He paid it all. Thank you, Jesus. This morning, I'm so glad. I'm so glad that I can live to see another Good Friday morning. There's so many that come this far and still never make it. But thank God. Thank God. We give him glory, honor, praise. Oh, hallelujah to his wonderful name. God does not treat us as how we treat him. He's a good God. He's a faithful God. He's a merciful God. He's a kind God. Hallelujah. This morning, Lord, we lift him up. We have to praise him. Hallelujah. Oh, God, for his fountain of blood that was shed for us. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, my God, by his stripes we are healed. Oh, Lord Jesus, from our sicknesses, from our disease, we have to lift our faith to him. Hallelujah. Except many dangers, calls, and snares, we have already come. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, Jesus, sin died where the blood fell. And oh God, we thank you, Jesus. Oh God, that you consider us as your own. Oh, let us worship him. Let us praise him. Let us give him glory because he has done so much for us. Sister Angela, I thank God for you. I bless you. There's no one ever invited me to this program. I found it on my own. Sometimes I might not in because I have to be here, there, and everywhere. You know, I love to sing, so I sing on the choir, so most of my time taken up somewhere else. And then, but to God be the glory, great things he have done. And I'm glad for each and every one that gave the testimony. The testimonies, oh my God, they are so good. They are encouraging. We have to encourage each one of us with our testimony, because if we don't have a testing, then we don't have a testimony. But because of Jesus Christ, through it all, we have learned to trust in Jesus. We have learned to trust in God. God bless you, my sister. God keep you. Oh God, let his face shine upon you and your family. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Thank you so much, Sister Amoy Johnson there in the UK. Thank you. Thank you for testifying from all over the world. God is good to you in the UK. He's good to you in the US. He's good to you in Canada. He's good all over the Caribbean. I saw my brother Peter there from Switzerland earlier on. Thank you so much for coming on board. We are just by here on this Good Friday celebrating the goodness of God. Amen. We're heading on up to the top of the hour when I'll have to leave. I have to eat breakfast. I gotta eat, amen, because we can't allow the glucose level to dip lower than it's supposed to go, amen. Trying to keep it in control. Oh glory. We can take another call if you are so moved. Peace and blessings to each and every one of you who lingered. Sister Diane there in Guyana, bless you. Sister Orinda in New Jersey, bless you. Sister Martha, you still there? Oh. Sister Elsie in Jamaica, bless you, bless you.
I am anointed.
My dear Sister Rosia in Guyana, in Jamaica. Rosia, Sister Rosia Goff in Jamaica, bless you and your household. Sister Jackie Rookwood, want to remind you that we are going into prayer this evening. It's Friday and the prayer team will be here. Send your prayer requests in, all right? Email admin, admin at zjoyvi.com. Or go to the website www.zjoyvi.com. Click on the prayer request tab at the top. Fill out the form as you scroll down. Get the prayer requests in. The enemy is under our feet, Pastor Earl. Sister Heather is still there from Trinidad. Brother Charles is still there from the Bahamas. Sister Marie Green, Jamaica, right? Sister Cleo, still there from Trinidad and Tobago. Sister Denise is there in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Sister Melly is still there too. St. Croix, St. Lucia.
I'm a mighty warrior in God's army.
the ferry. I will see you.
Back my peace, take it back. Back my joy, I'm taking back my health, take it back. And my wealth, I'm taking everything, take it back. It's torn from me.
Sister Shanette, bless you.
My family, I'm taking back my dance, take it back. And my shelter, take it back. For all the years, it tried to shut my mouth.
I am anointed.
We don't have to worry about anything, because God is with us, amen. He is the provider. So it may seem as though we are lacking certain things now. We have no lack in Jesus, amen.
You come back with your something then. You want to make sure you don't leave nothing standing. So you got to pick up your weapon. Pull it with the Holy Ghost blood. And point it at the enemy. Make sure you level everything when you
the come blood.
Up. Where do you say? There goes blood, blood.
Blood him up.
Blood, blood, blood,
blood, blood. Blood up the sicknesses. Pour the blood on all of those troublesome relationships. The blood, the blood, the blood. Pour the blood on your children who have gone astray. Keep on praying for them. The blood. We had people calling today to testify whose voice you've never heard, but they're there listening. So all of the silent listeners, bless you, bless you. We want to remind you to not only listen to people's testimony just for listening's sake, but hear the cries and pray, pray, pray. Amen. Let's continue to pray for one another. Nothing beats prayer. Prayer changes everything. I want to thank God for this time that we spent in His presence. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you for ZJoyVI. Thank you for the visionaries that you used, God, to establish this ministry. They thought we'd be dead by now, but we're still here. Going on 10 years. In about 3 months, God spare our lives. Thank God for each and every one of you who have decided to make the trek to the British Virgin Islands. You will not regret it. I pray for safe traveling mercies over each and every one of you. I pray that the Lord will fill your spirits so that you can bring something to the table as well. We are coming to encourage one another, to pray for one another, to fellowship with one another, and most of all, to give God the praise for what He has done for us. He has brought us together. It is not a mistake. He does not make mistakes. And so even those persons who have passed through the ministry that did what they did, said what they said, it has only served to catapult us higher in Jesus. And I'm glad about that. I thank God for each and every person who would have passed through this ministry. I thank God for those of you who are here. Thank God for those who will still come in. Because as a ministry, we have to grow in the Lord. Amen. We're not preaching to the choir only here. If you have a church and you're just preaching to the choir, same old people every day, something is wrong. You've got to grow. You've got to develop. Go out, do outreach. And that's what we're trying to do here at ZJoyVI. We're trying to reach the unreached. And so I encourage each and every one of you to continue to like and share the ministry. I can't do it on my own. Like and share, like and share. So that others will be blessed as well. Amen. May the peace of the Lord, which passes all understanding, rest, remain, and abide with each and every one of us now and forevermore. Amen, amen. Love you muchly, family. Really appreciate you. And as much as you give God thanks for me, remember, it's not me, it's God. It's God, amen. And I trust that you will always see the God in me as we come by here to worship the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Have a great rest of the day. Come back tonight for prayer. And Monday, yes, it's Easter Monday. It's another holiday in the islands, but I'll be here. God spare my life, I'll be here. So send in your spiritual nuggets, all right? We're taking it out with Ty Tribbett with this African medley. Thanks for calling in and testifying of the goodness of God. I was so blessed. Thanks, Sister Melly, for devotions. I will continue to walk in the favor of God. Hallelujah. Sister Janet Corey, God bless you.